You guys can be seated. Good morning. Jamom's out here. This is great. I just have to say that I am so glad that you are finally here. I have been looking forward to this day, and also a special message from Kathy Lori. She is down actually working in the nursery today in Orange County, doing children's ministry so that moms can attend down there. So she wishes she could be here, and she is wanted us to welcome you on her behalf as well. My name is Tiffany, and I work in the women's ministry here at Harvest, and I wanted to let you know that before any of you drove onto this campus or even stepped foot into this sanctuary, you have been prayed over. Your children have been prayed over, and your families have been prayed over. And our prayer today is that this would be just a time of refreshment and encouragement to you and your role as a mother. And we're hoping that today you can set this time apart just to pray and to plan and to prepare to be all that God has called you to be as a mother. In these next few moments, as we prepare our hearts and as we all split up and we go into the various workshops that we have prepared for you today, I want to just ask you just to stop for just 1 second and just clear your mind and just think about one thing. Just to pause and ponder and visualize one thing. Your children. Just think about them. If you have more than one, just think about them this morning. And as you do, I want to encourage you, as you're remembering those faces in your minds, I want to encourage you with these thoughts and these words as you do that. First, I want to encourage you to acknowledge. I want to encourage you to acknowledge that God's hand has been on your child, and his hand was on your child while they were being formed in your womb, and that he has designed your child according to his good plan, and he has designed you to be the mother of your child. I want to encourage you to accept God's design and special plan for your child, and encourage you to thank him for making your child just the way that they are. And I want to encourage you, thirdly, to affirm the purpose that God has for your child's life in creating your child for his glory and placing you in this role as your child's mother for his glory. And lastly, I want to encourage you to align yourself with God and his plan for your child's life. So as you're thinking of those faces today, remember to acknowledge, to accept, to affirm, and to align. And part of that alignment process is you being here today, you making that step, making the arrangements to be here today. You've come to pray, and you've come to plan, and you've come to be encouraged in a biblical way in your role as being a mother. I read a quote that I love, and it's kind of been reigning in my mind as we've been planning for this conference, and it says, "Mothering has never been an easy or a simple task. Every generation of mothers faces a unique set of challenges. Women have reared their children in war-torn lands, in plague-ridden villages, in famine-swollen refugee camps, and in covered wagons facing danger and hardship. The complexities and difficulties we confront are different, but like them, we must define the contribution we will make to the children given to our charge." And I loved that because it's so true. No matter the era, no matter the challenge, no matter the child, we're called to shepherd our children. We're called to contribute. And we're called as moms to shepherd them wholeheartedly and tenderly, no matter the cost. And in every generation, moms, you moms, are called to be what no one else can and called to do what no one else can do. Thank you for answering the call, and thank you for coming today to be encouraged in this role. I want to pray for you as you go. We have a lot planned for you today. We have 3 sessions of workshops. And as you go, I want to pray for you that the Lord will minister to your heart. So would you bow your heads and pray with me? Heavenly Father, we come before you now and we thank you so much for your love and your grace in our lives, especially as moms. I thank you for each mom here today that's come, that's made the arrangements and made the effort and the steps to get here this morning because they want to hear from you. They want to be encouraged in this special role that you've placed on their lives. And I just pray that you would encourage them. I pray that you would speak truth into their lives. We know that in your word, you tell us that children are, they're a heritage from you. They're a reward from you. You tell us that they're like arrows in the hands of a warrior. And you say, blessed is the man whose quiver is full of them. And I know that these women consider their children rewards and blessings and a heritage. And I just pray that you would bless them today, that they would, this time, that you would just honor it, that they've set apart from you. You tell us to teach our children to walk diligently. You tell us to talk to them about you when we sit and when we walk and when we lie down and when we rise up. And Lord, that's what we desire. So I pray that you would teach us today. Help us to learn and apply all that you have for us. In Jesus' name, amen.